Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Scratches, Director's Cut Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This is what happens if you call, Chief or former Police Chief Bailey again. It just rings, just in case you're curious. And I did record, like, almost an entire episode of me just wandering around, not accomplishing anything. So I did have to check a walkthrough really quickly, and I've missed some things and something that would not occur to me either. Let's go up here first. I didn't read too far ahead, guys, and I didn't even try it in practice yet. But I forgot all about this mirror. Know what, I guess, what it would be used for. One of the more obscure puzzles so far. See, I figured it was moving because we have something, you know, we want to reflect something, but... Wait. Is it not this one? Oh, we have to... Wait. Here. So now we... Was that sound me? I mean, I heard a little, like, pitter-pattering noise. It was the mirror I took from the main bedroom. Indeed it was. Now why I took this will shortly be made clear. This way, you guys, I don't bore you guys to death with my endless wanderings and not accomplishing anything. But that's what will often happen in adventure games. Now, before I head to this place where you will use the mirror, I did overlook something in the garage. We can take that. That's a crowbar. What it'll be used for, I don't know. It's a sturdy crowbar. Those things always come in handy. Yes, ask Gordon Freeman. I'm trying to move over here. Another interesting thing about the bicycle. I think... Ah! Yep. That's what the dynamo's for. It makes power from you turning the wheels. Pretty neat, huh? I mean, do they ever have bikes like that? Because that's a really good idea. Makes me wonder about that cask, but I'm pretty sure I got everything from here now. So now back to the crypt, which I cannot get from the outside of the house, at least as far as I know. Oh, no, we are going this way. Kinda hard getting to this place. We open and close so many doors, it's exhausting us. Downstairs. Now we want to see this more clearly. Well, I figured it's Robin. That wasn't useful. Well, we have to go upstairs, maybe. Because it's supposed to be a lookable thing for us to interact with. I think. The grate, right. Now this works in tandem with the rock somehow. Not sure how. Break the grate? Like I said, guys, I didn't try this in practice yet. We wanna... Well, that's not gonna help. There was no point in attaching the mirror to that holder. Maybe another holder. The idea was good, but I obviously needed more light to reflect. And for that we need the rock, but... I mean, I didn't look in depth in this. More light to reflect. Yeah, I really didn't look that closely, guys. I didn't want to spoil anything for myself. I mean, what? I know we used the rock in some way. Well, the shadow is falling here. Is there something on the ceiling? I'm gonna have to go look. Alright, let me just look really quick at this. And after this, we'll be blind again. Oh, there's a glass dome? I didn't even see that. Alright. So I'm not in the habit of looking up a lot of times. Okay, alright. Large windows in the dome above barely allowed sunlight to enter the room. This is where we use the rock. Got it. I hurled the stone at the window, but sadly it missed and bounced off the ceiling, flying out of sight. Okay. Did it fall back here? Or did it go below? I think it went below then. Rock. So it wasn't stuck that time. Where's the rock? Maybe it is back up there. Oh, no, there it is. Throw it again. Again, I hurled the stone at the window with all my strength, and this time my aim was true. The glass collapsed, throwing shards in every direction. Thankfully, none of them hit me. The sunlight was now intense in that spot. Maybe I could use it to my benefit. Ta-da. That side, but we want to look at the baby's one. Still? Even though it was in better shape than the rest, it was too dark in this particular spot to find out what the plaque read. Do we... Oh, that we didn't attach... The mirror got unattached? Did we actually attach that? Which one is the... Where are we? Oh, it's this one. I would have to somehow attach the mirror to the candle holder. Oh. With the wire. Here we go. The mirror now had wire attached to it. That part I figured out by myself, believe it or not. I didn't read that carefully. Several candle holders were attached to the wall. Oh, never mind. Thought it would say something new. Oh, I went down when I pressed at the mirror. Okay. R. The inscription was too eroded, but it seemed the name began with the letter R. No kidding. Well, I'll be curious to see if the baby is in there too. Because whoever's been hiding out here, granted, if they are alive, not undead, even if they are undead, they'd be eating something, right? Possibly these bodies. Maybe some rats. It was like one rat we found. Jerry's been mentioning rats. The place had rats at some point. So it's Robin. The name's Robin. Maybe Robin's hiding out here. Maybe Robin's death was faked. What? Yeah, I read that. So that doesn't give us much more info. I mean, we would already be able to see who... Can't go that way, can we? So where's the garden? Sounds like the sound was going backwards for a second. So I really didn't accomplish much. But we're probably going to need the crowbar for something. I mean, anyone who's played Half-Life could know that. Any more notes? No. Call Jerry? I'm really calling that bank one more time, too. Ask about James. I mean, there's no caller ID back then. Unless no one calls this bank. Like, oh my god, another call? It has to be this guy. He's the only guy who's called in the last 5 days. 0191294144. Glad I wrote this stuff down. I decided to stop pushing my lock. Okay then. Yet I fully dialed the number. I'm wondering if we gonna get another note from the electrician, or if what's her name's gonna write back. But she said she's off today. Oh, there's a letter here. Even though I was anxious to read the letter, I tried to remind myself that I should give a raise to my efficient assistant. Oh, so this is the transcribed letter. Okay. April 28th, 1963. Right? So this is after the death of Catherine, but before the death of Mr. Blackwood. What's his name? Richard? I forget his name. James Blackwood. Dear Mother, I spent the whole morning running a few errands for the Blackwood family, and on the way back, many thoughts crossed my mind. I take back what I said. I want to return home. Things haven't got any better here. Everyone is behaving mysteriously, and they try to avoid me. I do understand that they must still be disturbed about the death of their son, but it has been almost 2 years since that already. I feel like an alien. I don't belong here anymore. And I find it hard to sleep at night. There's too much activity in the house, too much moving around, and that is unnerving me. Smart girl. I feel something terrible is going on here, and I want to go away. And I want to go... So this is before the death of Mrs. Blackwood. Or was it... Her death was in May? Getting the dates mixed up. I didn't write them down. I feel something terrible is going on here, and I want to go as far away as possible. I will miss Mrs. Blackwood dearly, as she has always been kind to me, but I'm afraid my health is at stake. And I've been seeing some strange things, too. I can't explain it, but I think someone did something very wrong. That Dr. Milton would often come to talk with the sir for many hours, and nobody would allow me upstairs, although I've been secretly taking pictures there. I hope this doesn't upset you, but don't worry. They are well hidden under a loose board beneath my bedside table. Very good. Okay. Please, Mother, forgive me. I know I should have listened to you. It's not like I'm stubborn. I just wanted to wait and see if things would get any better for myself. They haven't. And that's why I'm asking you for a place to stay until I sort out my situation. Call me as soon as you can. I usually have to stay in town until 5 o'clock, but lately I've been coming back about an hour earlier. I just want to leave this place. I confess that I am scared. I'll be waiting, and please, hurry. With love, Eva. She never got to mail that letter. Sad to say. So we're just going to leave it in the mailbox. Okay then. Should we try Jerry again? Oh no, let's go check her her floorboard. Loose board, how she put it. I'm gonna find her body at some point. She never made it out of here. She never got to mail that letter. I want to move over there. Thank you. Move the rug? Where's the board? It's on the foot of her bed. Maybe. thought it was by her bed. No? Maybe I just assumed that. Because I don't have the letter with me, so I can't... have to go all the way back out to see. So let's just... start messing around. Maybe we gotta pull the... bed? I mean, the first thing I would do is move this rug. Literally clicking all over. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, that! But it's funny, it just turned me there automatically. That's him burying the wife. I see that. No new notes. Call Jerry. Check the newspapers, I guess, again. Figures. I thought I saw a face looking at me from that window. See if I can read another newspaper. Come on. Nothing new. What about the presence in the shadows? This keeps bothering me. I'm unsure where to go again. Let's check the mask room, I guess. Is the mask still there? I studied the mask and it silently stared back at me. I destroy it with the crowbar. It cannot be destroyed. Is that lantern always there? Oh! There was one other thing I spied from that. walkthrough. Forgot about it. Well, we can get into that greenhouse. Other way. At least I'm pretty sure we can. Is that the garden where that tree was? I forgot exactly how you get to it. It's somewhere along the way to the greenhouse. Further down. Because that's where she's probably still buried. This way. I mean, I don't know if this is the garden, it's just where a tree is. It actually doesn't look like much of a garden site to me. But then again, we did look at that picture. Might have to look again. Maybe the garden is in the greenhouse. No, it was outside. Never mind. I poured some oil on the hinges of the door and hoped it would reduce the rust. It did. A thick mist struck me in the eyes as I entered the barren greenhouse, and the smell of long dried plants and dirt permeated the air. Reflection or something there. Several pots were scattered here and there. A few had pathetic plants in them. Maybe he grows his food here. Doesn't look very appetizing. I was wondering how someone survives out here. With no obvious, you know, food delivery or anything like that. That's spooky sound. An imposing but dead tree adorned the center of the greenhouse. There was some kind of shiny object beneath the grating. Whatever it was, there was no way I could reach it. Well, use an item. Nope. Pry up the grating. I tried using the crowbar as a lever to lift that panel of the grating, but was totally welded to the rest. Huh. I'm just trying to drag it out. I got two matches left. We'll light it on fire. I am a paramaniac. I didn't need to do that. Alright, I guess never mind the shiny object for now. Anything else we can see from here? Not really. Oh, this. One of the pots had collapsed, spreading its contents over the concrete floor. And another one collapsed. A huge pot containing a bush had fallen, blocking the drain. If we drain the water. Do we want to unblock the drain? Yeah, I don't know. Okay. This is the creepiest greenhouse I've ever been in. I wonder if whoever was sneaking around is watching my every move. Damn, he's in the greenhouse now. Is there anything we want over here? That's a reflection. I want the shiny object. I don't know what it is. A key, maybe? A sliver of glass? An interesting thing? The upper walkway was livelier than below due to several plants that somehow managed to subsist on it. Maybe someone's been watering them. A rope! That's right, we used my rope. I can't get this rope. A shovel, so we can dig up Mrs. Blackwood. The branches of the huge tree made walking in the upper walkway very difficult. Let's go this way first. I see like a wheel or something. Wait. Apparently the water wasn't running. Oh, he went back downstairs. I didn't mean to do that. I thought it was further up the tree, but there was another... never mind. So that way just goes downstairs. But... where was I looking that I had seen? Oh, now I went over here. It was just an old fumigator. The watering can was of no use to me as I had no plans to try reviving any of these plants. One bag had ripped, spreading dirt all over the table. An unopened bag of fertilizer was lying on the table. The plant on top of the table was strangely attractive. Really? Are we attracted to plants now? Can I open these? Look what we got. That could be a dangerous implement indeed. The shears were tailored for trimming plants. I want to close the drawer. Thank you. A letter? Huh. February 7th. As much as I regret it, I've decided to stop caring for the greenhouse. All my efforts to save the plants have been in vain. I just can't seem to figure out what is wrong with them. You notice we have no, years on these. Could be very recent. It has been a few weeks since they began falling apart to pieces, dying without any apparent cause. It's the curse. Some of them would just crumble at the slightest touch. This is not only frustrating, but very unsettling. Every time I enter the place, I can feel a sense of dread and decay. What I most regret is the condition of that rare plant I brought from South Africa. It's now all sad-looking and almost dried up. I will take it upstairs and look after it, hoping that it will get more sunlight, assuming that everything that has been happening here has a natural explanation. Okay, I guess this is that plant, right here. Death is surrounding this place and I can't seem to do anything about it, in spite of my concerns. I can't help thinking that all of this began when I brought that... I wonder... No, I have to put those thoughts aside. I should stop reading all those sinister books. They're getting under my skin. Who wrote that? The doctor? Pack it up, baby. I took a few leaves with me. Oh, okay. I had taken a few leaves and fruits from that strange African plant. They had a very particular smell. Put it on the plate. Feed it to whoever's out there. Have some stuff. This will make you turn into a normal human being again. That'll probably make you even worse, actually. Alright. Pathetic plants. This goes all the way out. Does it? It can't go all the way out the window. I don't see a break in the window. Not useful. Now, where did I see some kind of crank? That's where I saw it. A large hose was lying on the walkway. Ah, I did. I can take it. Or I attached it. I'm gonna water the tree? What am I doing exactly? The watering can I couldn't take, right? What am I doing with the hose? I was just trying to take it. Actually, I thought it was a rope. Oops. Maybe that's what I saw. The water wasn't running. Okay, well, I've attached it. We're gonna pour water in so I get the shiny object? Maybe now. Oh, I want that shovel. There was a shovel in the planter, but it was stuck in the soil. We'll unstick it. I'll plier it loose. Some WD-40. Because I want to dig up Mrs. Greenwood. Dig her up, dig her up, dig her up, dig her up. Yeah, I don't know how we... Maybe the item can be used to detach that. Been running quite a while. Let's see if he wants the watering can yet. Take it. You want to pour water in. Okay. He has ideas that I hadn't thought of, and then I have ideas that he can't fulfill. I mean, obviously I still need water if I get the watering can, but it's a start. So we have this hose attached. Removed a few branches and leaves, clearing that corner of the drain. That part of the drain was already cleared, so I didn't have to keep cutting the plant. Well, maybe I want to. So the drain is cleared. There's a hose. We just need water. Just checking, maybe... Maybe he won't grab that until... we have everything else in place. I have managed to get inside the greenhouse, another one of Blackwood's hobbies. This place is really sad, and the atmosphere is dense. Maybe we have to go outside and attach some... I mean, get the water running from out there? Take a look at it now. I'm pretty sure we want to raise the level to get that item to lift up, float up. But the water's not running anywhere around here, so I'm not sure how I would do that. But we've been running quite far enough already. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.